Chris McHenry, and I live here in Old Lake Highlands where we're currently sitting, and every morning I've been driving to work and I see you, Chris, out painting. And just the other day I stopped and asked you what the story was, and so tell us a little bit about what you're doing here. Do you live in the neighborhood?
Yes, I do. My wife and I just live a few blocks over. We've lived here for about 10 years, and I've been doing paintings of the White Rock Lake area, White Rock in particular, for probably 20 years.
Yeah.
And I've just been wanting to do paintings of our neighborhood for a long while now, and so a couple months ago I said, well, this is a good time to get started. Yeah. Actually, it wasn't a good time. It was the middle of the summer, and it was like 106 degrees out the first day I went out. And my wife said, are you crazy?
Yeah.
Because it was like, I kept thinking, okay, I'm going to go. And it was in the springtime when I thought I would go. But by the time I finally got everything wrapped up to where I could do it, it was the middle of the summer. But so I started doing it, and I started setting up on the corners because I could set up and there would be a good view and there would be good light. Mm-hmm. That's my main thing. That's what I'm looking for, is good light.
Right.
And so on the corners there aren't a lot of trees in the way and you get good lights on the house. And I like the houses in our neighborhood, the 50s style houses. And I like the way, one of the things I didn't notice, like the house I'm painting right here, I had already painted one exactly like this. It's the same floor plan and everything.
Uh-huh.
And if you look around, the lady that lived there pointed out to me that there's similar, exactly the same houses, but they've been repainted. And so over the years, they've kind of developed their own personality.
Right.
So in my paintings, that's what I'm trying to capture. I'm trying to capture a classic look, but it's over the years, it's taken on a personality of its own.
Uh-huh. Yeah, how many of these intimate one-house paintings have you done in the neighborhood so far?
Well, I'm naming them. This is number 13 right here.
Wow.
And I'm just calling them neighborhood painting number 1, 2, and I'm going to do a whole series of them.
Okay.
So it'll be a finite number of paintings.
And do you have any grand idea of how many it's going to end up being?
I don't. When I first started out, I didn't know whether it would work or not. I didn't know how people would take it, just setting up in front of their house.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody's been real, real nice about it.
And nobody's run you off yet?
So far, no. I'm
not good.
So far, everybody's been very, very accepting and very nice.
Mm-hmm.
And I've met a lot of our neighbors.
Now, as far as your background, what have you done before fine art painting?
When I first went off to college, I studied architecture.
Uh-huh.
And so my first year, that's what I studied. But the requirements for architecture are a lot of, you take a lot of art courses, and I decided that's what I liked better. And so I switched over to fine art and went to the University of New Orleans. I studied fine art there. I worked in a shipyard in summer and in nighttime and went to school at University of New Orleans.
Wow.
And while I was there, I decided I needed to get some kind of job that I could make some money and also do, pursue my art. So I got a job painting billboards when I was in New Orleans.
Uh-huh.
And I did that for about 10 years. That's what brought me to Dallas in the first place.
Yeah. Now, what's your eventual plan for these series of neighborhood paintings?
I don't have a grand scheme yet. What I've found in the past is if I paint stuff that I'm really interested in, and if it comes out good, one thing will lead to another.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm thinking I'll probably have a show of these paintings sometime within the next year,
mm-hmm.
but I haven't worked out the specifics yet.
Gotcha. And do you anticipate doing this same thing again in another neighborhood?
Well, that's part of the reason I chose this subject. I was looking for something that I could grow with, something that was a recognizable style that's my own. I don't see a whole lot of other artists doing, neighborhood paintings like this. But it also gives me room to grow into something else. I mean, I could easily do like Lakewood or the M Streets. There's some interesting houses over there.
Mm-hmm.
And so and of course Highland Park, there's a lot of interesting houses. It's a different scale of house, and so it would be a different, but yeah, there's a lot of room to grow.
Maybe you could set up in front of President Bush's new house when they move back to Dallas and paint it.
Well, that would be a possibility. I don't know how that much they would appreciate that.
Well, you never know. You might meet some interesting Secret Service people.
And probably so.
Well, Chris McHenry, I know you've got some of these up on your website, and people can go there and look at them.
Yeah, www.chrismchenry.com.
All right. Well, thanks so much for talking with us, Chris.
Well, I enjoyed meeting you and talking to you.
Okay.